Hello, everybody. So I saw Miranda Hayes make this awesome cliches book tag, and it just seemed really fun and interesting, and she said anybody who wanted to do it was tagged, so here I am, doing it. The idea being that we pick a bunch of cliches that are just common things we use in our language all the time and pick a book that applies to them. So right off the bat, we're going to start with Actions Speak Louder Than Words, a book where the movie adaptation was much better than the book. For that, I have to say A League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. This comic book was actually so bad, I don't even own it anymore. I read the first two volumes and couldn't stand them, traded them into my used bookstore for something else. The comics were just not good at all. They were so weirdly paced, they were super uncomfortably sexist and rapey, they were just not fun, and I was so disappointed because I loved that movie. The same team does V for Vendetta, which I've been told is also a much better movie than comic books, so maybe this is just not a comic I should go with. Sorry, Alan Moore. Number 2, The Grass is Always Greener on the Other Side. And I'm gonna say Percy Jackson. He had a really difficult childhood, he wondered who his real dad was, he had these troubles in school, and then found out about this amazing world of Camp Half-Blood, these freaking Poseidon's son. But turns out, all this other terrible shit starts happening because of that, and he faces so many more challenges. So I think it's really accurate to Grass is Greener on the Other Side, since it always turns out, actually, no matter which side of the fence you're standing on, the other looks better. But of course, Percy Jackson's an awesome hero and rises to the occasion anyway. Number 3, The Apple Doesn't Fall Far From the Tree. Who is a parent-kid combo that you love? And for this, I'm also saying Rick Riordan's writing. This time I'm saying The Kane Chronicles. Carter Kane and his dad are really similar, and his dad is just so cool. Like, he's just a cool dad. I don't know how else to explain it. Carter is really similar to him. They spend so much time together, and they're really best friends. I think his sister is also very similar to their mom, so you kind of have both sides of that apple tree situation. Next up, you should never judge a book by its cover. What book do you think needs a redraw? And for that, I'm gonna say Scarlet, which is the second book in the Lunar Chronicles series. This series has some freaking amazing covers. The cover of Cinder made me want to read this whole series, and this one is just really lacking. The character Scarlet doesn't even actually wear a cape, she has a hoodie, and the spine looks terrible on my shelf. I wish this cover matched the beauty of the others. But accurate to the saying, the book itself is freaking phenomenal, so don't let that bad, bad cover make you decide not to read it. Number 5, You Can't Please Everyone. And for that, I'm gonna go with Stephenie Meyer's Twilight. Twilight is just this book series where people really do either love it or hate it. There doesn't seem to be much of a middle ground, and it's kind of a fandom of people hating it as well as a fandom of people loving it. I enjoy this series, I think it's really fun. Does it have its problems? Sure, but overall, I enjoy the experience of reading these books. What doesn't kill us makes us stronger, and for that I'm going with Wink, Poppy, Midnight. I can't say why I'm choosing this book without it being a really big spoiler, but if you've read it, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And if you haven't read it, you should, it's a really good book. Also, look how pretty, so pretty. Love is Blind, a book with a disabled character, and for that I do have a blind character. We got Toph from Avatar The Last Airbender. Toph is awesome, she never lets her disability slow her down. She's blind but sees the world in this really awesome way, and the Avatar universe actually includes more than just her in terms of disabilities. Kato is one of my favorite characters. He hasn't appeared in the comic books, he's just in the TV show. He's the young boy in the wheelchair who lives in the air temple. But this once again proves that literally everything about the Avatar universe is brilliant and wonderful, and I'm guessing some people still don't know the comic books exist. A lot of people don't seem to, but if you loved the show, you should be so happy about the comics. They're really, really good. Ignorance is Bliss. Name a book where you're just happy to not be aware of its flaws. And for that, I am choosing The Friday Society by Adrienne Kress. I loved this book. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars on Goodreads. It was so much fun. I just enjoyed the whole experience. But a lot of people hated on it in their reviews on Goodreads because it's not true to steampunk and it doesn't really live up to that genre well enough. I don't know much about steampunk. I'm not by any means a steampunk aficionado. And I love this book, so I'm happy to remain just ignorant about the steampunk issues because it was super fun to read. Number 9, There's No Time Like the Present. Read a contemporary book that you think matches this category. And for that, I'm gonna say A Little Something Different. Not only is this contemporary, but it's in contemporary romance, which is usually a recipe for disaster for me. I avoid this genre at all costs, and yet I loved this book. Sandy Hall is brilliant. She wrote a really sweet story with a whole bunch of different narrators, and it was just really clever and wonderful and current. Current. I'm losing my voice. It was honestly just a pleasure to read. It felt very realistic and honest, and I can't wait to read more of her books. I can't even believe I'm saying that I want to read more contemporary romances. Like, what is she even doing to me? I don't know, but I love it. I'm so glad. And last, but certainly not least, another cliche, but not the one I'm talking about, Better Safe Than Sorry, a book that you picked up, but after reading a bunch of bad reviews, you're thinking maybe I shouldn't do this after all. And that is the second book in the School for Good and Evil series. Not only does this have some pretty mixed reviews, but I also read the first book and really didn't enjoy it. I'm holding on to this copy because I'm not completely ready to give up on it, but I don't know. I think it's better to be safe than sorry on this one, not waste my time reading it. If you read this book and loved it, please tell me. I'm happy to have this book championed. I just don't know if I should bother. And that's it. Those are the 10 cliches for today. If you enjoyed this video, you should subscribe to my channel so you can see more stuff, and you should absolutely do it yourself. If you want to see Miranda's original video, I'll link to it below along with my Goodreads account so you can follow me there, and I will see you next time.